This is Driving Wiz6. Huh. Look at this. The Focus ST. Awesome.
Today I'm driving the Toyota. I'm on my way to pick the car up now. I'll start by saying that I do have a lot of respect for Toyota. They build good quality products, very reliable, and they have good resale value. They are unfortunately a little bit boring. There are two exceptions though. First of all, the Lexus LFA, which is a Toyota on steroids. And then, according to Wheels magazine, this magazine here, I'm holding the latest copy in my hand. According to them, in the buyer section at the back of their up-to-date magazine, they speak of the Toyota Zealous. This is what it looks like. Wheels says that it is a much needed, or sorely needed to use the correct words, budget sports coupe, which has 176 horsepower and, unfortunately, an automatic gearbox. Well, I'm just wondering what Wheels is going to do when they discover that for nearly a year now, we have had the Toyota 86 in the UAE. The Toyota 86 has nearly 200 horsepower, is also rear-wheel drive, and has a manual gearbox. I think they're going to pee their pants with excitement when they find out. And who knows, maybe they'll update their car buyer guide. Okay, back to today. I'm borrowing the car from a friend, as I don't own a Toyota myself, and this friend of mine is a rugby player. Now, for those of you who do not know, rugby is a very hard, very violent sport played by hard, violent men. So the very last thing I should do is make fun of that. Okay, back to the Toyota. Obviously, I'm still in the Focus, and with the help of the magic of movies and a bit of teleportation, just by snapping my fingers, I will transport myself into the Toyota. So, here we go. Okay, that didn't work. Let's try it again. Magic. Okay, this is the Toyota. It's a Toyota Fortuner. Very comfortable, hard plastics, but comfortable, and a very commanding driving position. So, shall we give it a bash? There we go, the automatic gearbox is selected to drive. Let's go. Yeah, well, there's, oh my word, okay, well, where was I? So, the Toyota's not a bad car to drive, but nothing wrong with it at all. Seems quite pleasant, and anyway. Man, thank heavens for these speed bumps. My goodness, how do people do this?
This is really hard.
I obviously don't give Toyota drivers nearly enough credit for driving their cars, and it's very no wonder they're all over the road.
Anyway, so
it's like I've lost the will to live.
It's just
really bad. I think I could take it.